Dear friends, through this course, we are considering balancing of redox reactions or balancing of chemical reactions. And up till now, what we have considered, let us go ahead. And in this part, we are now going to focus on oxidation number of an element, although I have written an element, oxidation number of an atom of an element, because in a compound there can be two atoms of same element. For example, if I write K2Cr2O7, so oxidation number of potassium is plus 1. In periodic table, potassium is below sodium, and alkali metals have oxidation number of plus 1. They have tendency to donate one electron, NaCl, Na plus 1. Yesterday, during the last lecture, we have studied it, considered it. Similarly, potassium will carry plus 1 charge, and such two potassium atoms in the form of K plus 1 are present here. So, to be perfect, oxidation number of an atom of an element in the compound, or in simple terms, charge on an element, charge on an, same thing, on an atom of an element, on an atom of an element. This part we are going to focus, and also along with this, in this lecture, we are going to consider charge on certain groups, charge on certain groups. So this is what we are going to consider here. Now, we'll start with very simple example, hydrogen. Now, hydrogen, as we know, the electronic configuration, as hydrogen has only one electron, elemental form. In 11th, 12th, the higher level study, we are going to consider modern methods, then we will write electronic configuration of hydrogen in this manner, not now. So hydrogen has one electron in its orbit, and therefore hydrogen during compound formation has oxidation number of plus 1. Hydrogen can form one covalent bond. So if hydrogen is plus 1, if we know oxidation number, or if we know the charge on that atom in that compound of certain elements, few elements, from that, by using that, we can develop or calculate mathematically the oxidation number or the charge of many more atoms of elements or many more groups. Let me explain few simple we should know to start with. Sodium, even sodium, atomic number is 11, has oxidation number of plus 1. Potassium, as we have considered, oxidation number of plus 1, because during compound formation, potassium has tendency to donate one electron. Now, on the basis of octet theory, that can be explained, but the limit of the topic which we are considering or focusing on, here we should avoid few things. Those are to be considered during those specific topics. Potassium is plus 1. So, hydrogen, sodium, potassium in their compounds have plus 1 oxidation state. Now, there are few exceptions for hydrogen also. In their hydride form, for example, NaH compound, sodium is metal, sodium is always plus 1, so hydrogen becomes minus 1. Such few exceptions are there, but since I have told you earlier that we are considering 10th standard level chemistry, and therefore few things we will avoid, and we'll focus on only those things which are in majority or which we should know first. So sodium, potassium, hydrogen in their compounds carry plus one charge. Halogens, oxidation number, or in simple terms if you call it as charge is minus one. Now once we know charge on certain elements, how the charge on other elements in their compounds can be found, the very example which we have considered, NaCl. Now total charge on a compound should be equal to zero. Why? Because during a compound formation, total donated electrons, total number of electrons donated should be equal to total gained electrons during compound formation. Especially we are focusing on ionic compounds or considering that the compound is ionic. In NaCl, as we know, sodium is in the compound, sodium is always plus one. If sodium is plus one and compound as a whole, the charge should be zero because total donated electrons and total gained electrons, sodium donates electron, chlorine gains, the total should be equal. So in NaCl, it automatically means that if sodium is plus one, chlorine is minus one. So Cl is minus one. If such type of simple examples by considering, if we have developed a chemical way of thinking, then it becomes possible for us to find the charge or the oxidation number of elements. Now once we know that hydrogen is plus one, molecular formula of water is known to us. Now hydrogen carries plus one charge. So plus one charge carrying hydrogen, such two are present, means total is plus two. Molecule as a whole, the total of all the charges, it should be zero. Therefore, oxygen carries minus two, and therefore, oxidation number of oxygen, one atom of oxygen in the compound is equal to minus two. Even like what I have told you, hydrogen has certain exceptions, but we are not going to consider that. We are going to neglect that. Similarly, oxygen in very few examples has certain different oxidation states, but those are the examples which we are going to consider in our higher standards. Minus two is the oxidation state or oxidation number of oxygen, or minus two is the charge on oxygen in the compound. Once we know this, then just one example I will explain, and then for the further explanation I have to remove this. Now just consider the example of sodium oxide. What should be the formula of sodium oxide? The formula of sodium oxide is Na twice O. We need not memorize such things, because as we know now that sodium carries plus one charge in its compound, plus one sodium, such two are there, and now from water we have calculated in the compound oxygen has oxidation number minus two, oxygen, the charge on oxygen is minus two, and such one atom of oxygen is present, therefore minus two, plus two, minus two match each other, and therefore total sum of positive and negative comes to be zero, and therefore oxide of sodium, the formula is Na twice O. and nothing else. Similarly, suppose that I wish to write the molecular formula of magnesium oxide. Magnesium oxide, as this we have written in our, even in our 9th, 8th standards, magnesium oxide we write in this fashion. Why this? The very simple reason is that magnesium has tendency, because electronic configuration, magnesium electronic configuration is this, and magnesium during compound formation, molecular formation, has tendency to donate two electrons. If it donates two electrons, its octet will be complete, and therefore magnesium carries plus two charge. And since in the compound, as we have just now considered, oxygen carries minus two charge, and the total charge, the sum, the addition of all the positive and negative charges, it should be zero. 1 plus 2 magnesium balances one atom of minus 2 oxygen, and the molecular formula of magnesium oxide is MgO, while that of sodium oxide is Na2SO. These are very preliminary simple examples, but to start with, we have to consider such simple examples, then confidence is developed. The logic or the sequence of basics required for study of chemistry is developed, and then further few examples and more complicated examples can be considered.